This demonstration will show how to use OBS Studio for the purpose of recording of e-lectures or educational videos. So I have already installed OBS Studio on my system. So the icon will look like this, OBS Studio. Once you install the OBS Studio after downloading from Google, now I'm opening it. So this is the basic layout. The OBS system will look like this. So now you have to do the settings to start it operating. So it has, you can see there is a scene on the left, extreme left, sources in between, audio meter on the right of the sources, and there is a control panel also where you can see the start streaming, start recording studio mode. Here you can also, there is different mode also where one would like to do the switchings and all, but for the purpose of e-lecture we are using only this mode, that is a full screen studio mode. Now the point is how to bring in the webcam video. So first of all, you can see on the screen there is a plus button at the bottom of the scenes column. So you need to add a scene. So already scene one is there, so we are renaming it scene two as a webcam. As webcam. So what I have done, I have created a scene 2 and renamed it as webcam. So this scene has been created. Now you need to assign a source to it. So assigning a source, you need to go to the source. So first I'm clicking on the plus button. So because you need to add the video cam to it, the video camera to it, so you need to have the you need to assign video capture device to webcam. So once you press the button of plus and video capture device, so one window will open. So you can see the window has opened. I'm sitting in the green screen, so that's why the window is showing as green. As I'm pressing the OK button, so one scene has been created, webcam, but you can adjust it as you want. Like I am adjusting to full screen, I have adjusted as the full screen. So once this has been done, the second important thing is like how to remove the green. So I'm going to tell you how to remove the green. So for that, again you have to go to the video capture device and click on the right of it. So here one option is there, filter. So if you press the filter button, again it gives you lots of option. After pressing on the filter option, the window like this will open on the screen. So now you press the button plus. After pressing the plus button, you will see the lots of options on the panel. So one option is chroma key. This is what is required to remove the green. So I'm applying the chroma key. So I'm taking the chroma key here. So once I bring in the chroma key, you can see the green background has been removed, and the flat black screen is there. So now one more option here you can use is the color correction. If you want like little color correction is required. So I'm adding the color correction option. So it is giving you the option to do the color corrections. Here you can increase the contrast if you find it like I'm trying to increase the contrast a little bit, I'm trying to increase the brightness of a little bit. These are the different buttons, you know, as you find it suitable, you can select the options, you can increase and decrease the contrast, brightness and other options. So once this is done, I'm closing it. So this is the final output that you would be able to see on the screen. Now the point is how to bring in the presentation. So for that, we need to have a screen capture option. So I'm creating another scene. Let me press the plus button. This is, I'm keeping it as screen. I have taken as screen. And in the screen, now again, after I have selected one scene, so we'll have to assign a source to it. So what is the source? So to assign the screen source, we need to press the plus button, and here I have pressed the plus button, and you can see that there is lots of menu. In this menu we need to assign display capture, because we need to capture the screen. So here we will be adding the display capture to it. So immediately after, you know, adding the display capture, the the OBS has already started capturing and showing on the preview menu. As you can see now, one scene is of the webcam output, that is video output, and the second output is the screen, that is a laptop screen. Now, third important point is to merge the two layers, merge these two layers so that the presentation goes at the back and video comes in the front. So for that, we need to assign one more display layer to this webcam. So what I'll do, I'm adding the display capture to it. So display capture 2 has been added. Now we need to bring the back layer to the front and send the front layer to the back. So that can be done simply by bringing it down. So now you can see two layers are on the same screen, now have been merged, but of course you would like your picture, your video to be, you know, properly kept in the corner of the presentation. So what I do, just touch at the corner of this or the red outlines of the that shows on the screen. So with that you would be able to make it small or big. So what I'm doing is just using those cursors and I'm using it, keep the video in the corner. So this is how I have kept the video in the corner. Now this is all set for the recording. Now how to bring the presentation? I have kept it on the desktop, so I'm opening the presentation. So this is the presentation that I want to use for the OBS Studio. So first we need to put it as a full screen. So this is the presentation. In this presentation, we'll be talking about conservation of biodiversity in northeastern regions. So as it says, the global goal as per 2015 Life on Land, the conservation motto says the protect, restore and promote sustainable use of terrestrial ecosystems. So this, you can use the presentation for the e-lecture. I have kept a small video also in this presentation. So you can also use the small videos, animation in the presentation to show. Graphs can be used. So when your presentation is done, you can press the F6 button to stop recording. So I hope through this demo, you would have understood how to utilize OBS Studio to record the e-lecture educational videos on your own. So hope you find this video interesting and worthy. Thank you.